Welcome back, 412-575-2600 on the Bordas and Bordas hotline. Let's jump right into it. We will start with Judy in Springdale, my favorite Saturday night caller. Good evening, Judy.
Hi, Professor.
How are you?
Listen, how am I?
Yeah, how are
I'm going to fall asleep. I already put my clocks back.
It's a 1035 show,
Judy. Okay, Duquesne won really good.
Yes, they did. Shout out to Duquesne.
Did you see Slippery Rock? They won by 3 points in the last, was it 2 seconds or 2 minutes with
wow.
one of those short football kicks.
Okay, sure field goal to win it. Well, congratulations 31. To Slippery Rock.
What, honey?
Congratulations to Slippery Rock. And, of course, congratulations
Chad.
To Duquesne.
Chad, he's leading in sacks, too. Boy, I'm getting good at this. Sitting here with my eyes shut so I can't see you. That's all until, is there a game next week?
I got to double check the schedule. I'm not sure, but we'll figure it out. We'll talk soon.
Okay, honey, have fun.
Thanks, Judy.
Thanks,
have a good night.
Bye.
Judy likes to call me every week to tell me how her grandsons are doing. Of course, she mentioned Duquesne beating St. Francis. That's a pretty big rivalry in the NEC. 30-21, Duquesne beat St. Francis. Big win for head coach Jerry Schmidt. He surpasses former head coach Greg Catuzzo with 98 career wins. He now passes Greg Catuzzo's 97 on the Duquesne all-time coaching wins list for head coaches. So congratulations to Coach Smith. Has done an outstanding job since taking over. Here's the thing. When Coach Schmidt took over, this was a non-scholarship program that moved into the NEC, became a scholarship program. They have now gone to the FCS playoff twice, and he's become a big-time player in that Northeast Conference. So congratulations to Coach Schmidt. Has done an outstanding job at Duquesne. Also taking your tweets at Josh Taylor HD, but let's go back to the phone lines. Joe in Greensburg. Joe, you're on the Nightly Sports Call.
Hey, thank you for having me. Moncrief, the money he signed for, all that money he signed for, him getting cut, will he get that money?
Good question. I want to say the money that he actually got paid, obviously, he gets that. I'm not sure the percentage of how much he gets the rest of it. I got to look that up to be 100% sure. I'm pretty sure some of it goes against the cap next year. I think that's how it works. I don't know if he gets it all right away. It's real strange how all that kind of shakes out as far as salary cap numbers go, because sometimes we look at the salary cap number and we look at the number that the player got, and those numbers don't always match. So it's kind of hard to know for sure. I have to double check that one and get back to you. We got Jordan in White Oak. Jordan, you're on the Nightly Sports Call.
Hey, how you doing?
Good, how are you?
Good. Just calling about that big Penn State Ohio State game coming up in a couple of weeks. How do you think that one's going to play out?
Well, thanks for the call. I said this, I think, a week ago. I was glad that Penn State beat Michigan State because they needed to. It was a big road win that they needed to get. I was glad they beat Michigan because it was something they needed to do. They needed to beat one of the bigger teams in that division. But I said the big challenge were these two road games coming up. You got to go to Columbus and beat Ohio State, and you got to go to Minnesota. And believe it or not, you got to deal with P.J. Fleck. I don't think Minnesota is going to be an easy win for them. So, yeah, I think this is one of those things where Penn State's going to have to deliver in a tough game, in one of the toughest environments in college football. But I said this last week also, this is one of the most balanced teams I've seen from Penn State in recent memory. Because we've seen in past years, maybe they're strong at one position, maybe they're strong at another position, but there's maybe some deficiency somewhere else. Everywhere I look on this depth chart, they have guys that I look at and say, okay, they can at least do the job at the level that they're expected to play at. This is one of the more evenly put together teams that I've seen, and I like that about Penn State. But let's not kid ourselves. Penn State's been doing pretty well, at beating teams that they're supposed to beat. But you got to beat the tougher teams in your division. Now, they've gotten themselves to the Big Ten championship game and won. They did it one time. But if you want people to take you seriously, if you want to start being talked about in the same conversation as Ohio State, if you want to be talked about in the same conversation as Wisconsin, as teams that are perennially in the hunt for the Big Ten championship game, you got to win games like this one. You got to beat Ohio State, got to beat them in the horseshoe. It just becomes very, very apparent, and it becomes imperative. But it's also important that you can't look past a team like Minnesota either. Both of those things are equally important. Something else I wanted to bring up here while we're talking about football. We'll go from football to football, so to speak. Our friends over at the Riverhounds, their season comes to an end this evening in the Eastern Conference semifinals. They lose 2-1 to Louisville City FC in extra time. Down to the last couple minutes, they had to play 30 minutes of extra time because they did not have a clear winner after the original 90 minutes. But the Riverhounds suffer a 2-1 loss. And that was their first loss at home since May of 2018. They had an amazing streak going as far as avoiding losses at home, and they played so well this season. They won the number one seed in the Eastern Conference, but their season comes to an end at the hands of Louisville SC. A couple other things that I want to bring to your attention. Here we go to Twitter. Joe says, do you think the Steelers should have put in a waiver claim on Josh Gordon? Great question. Our producer, Jared, he and I literally talked about this, I think, a couple times this week alone. We talked about the possibility of the Steelers maybe putting in a waiver claim on Josh Gordon. I know Jared believes that they should have. He thought it was something that they should have done. I'm one of those people. If there's a guy out there, you think he can help you, if he's healthy, why not kick the tires? It's just one of those things. If anything, just ask. Just see what's going on. Just see how things look. And if you do try to put a waiver claim in, it's not a terrible idea. I thought it's something that I don't think they would have lost anything by trying. I guess that's a better way to put it. I don't think there's much to really, as far as opportunity costs, but they could have lost in trying to put a claim on Josh Gordon. And I will say this much. When you look at this wide receiving core right now, especially since we're all accepting the fact and we're all admitting and agreeing that this situation with Dante Moncrief did not go the way we wanted it to. I think we're all accepting that. We're all agreeing on it. This was one of those times where teams in the Steelers' position try to make a move to get a guy that can help them. Usually, especially a team that's contending in this position, in this situation, they're going to try to get a guy that can help you out, especially if that guy might be better than some of the guys you have at that position. And I think Josh Gordon's one of those guys that fit that category. Now, I know a lot of people might not feel so great about bringing Josh Gordon on because of his past history, and that's a good concern to have, especially considering the Steelers' own recent history with wide receivers and guys getting in trouble and suspensions and things of that nature. So, yes, it's a big concern on different ends of it. But at the same time, I'm one of those folks that thinks if you have a guy here, I think he's proven in the past couple years he's willing to keep himself out of trouble and do the things that he needs to do to get back into the league, and I think he could have helped this team. So, yeah, I really do wonder the reasoning for not trying to put a waiver claim in and having him be claimed by Seattle. Going to take another break. We'll have some more phone calls and tweets when we come back. Stick around.